I'm John Gogan, and I'm going to show how math applies in real life for your job, for your rent, and for a lot of other things.
Hello, we're going to be talking about my spreadsheet today. We're having a problem with multimedia, so I'll just be indicating with this pencil, this amazing, godly pencil. My first column is the salary. I make $2,500 a month for month one. And same for month two and month three. My savings will be 15% for all three of them. And my total income will be the same. My rent will always be the same because of the rent really never changes, but my food will change. My first month, I will have $200, or I'll pay $200 for food. My second month, I'm gonna pay $210 for food. And my third month, I'll pay $195. I eat at good restaurants, I buy my own food, and I go for fast food sometimes for all of them. And now we're moving on to utilities. I'll pay $120 for the first month, $115 for the second month, and $110 for the third month. The utilities that I use for all three of the months are only electric and gas. My monthly cell phone bill is $55 a month each month, except the third one because I actually overran my data plan because I texted too much to my friends. And yeah, and my transportation will be the same for $200 each month. And it's always $200 a month because I just take the train each month and I have a train card, and that's how it happens. Because that's how you do it here in Orlando, Florida. My clothing, I'll pay for the first month $60 or dollars because I bought a few clothes, and I bought a t-shirt for the second month, which is $65. Cheap one, you know, not a lot. And I'll pay $60 in the third month again. For my entertainment, I'll go for $200 to go to the movies, to go to the mall, and buy things. And then the second one, I am actually going to do $300 because I think I'm going to need more things off of the starting thing. And then I'm actually going to lower it because I have most of my stuff bought that I would like and love. My extra expenses will be actually firefighter equipment because I want to buy better firefighter equipment than what they actually pay. For all 3 months, it'll be $350. And you also want better training equipment for these so I can rise to the rank of captain because I want to get more money. Yes! And my total expenses for the month one will be $1,995. Month two will be $2,105. Month three will be $1,970. My savings for month one will be $130 or dollars because, you know, I'm a firefighter and I just started out. Second month, I spent a bunch of money and I'll only have $20 because that's how I roll. And my third month, I was pretty set, so I saved $155. Now I'm going to show you the apartment that I rented for $810 a month. Here's the picture of a pool that is actually in the apartment. Top floor, here's another picture of it on a different angle. Here's the front of it. We actually are very close to everything, even the apartment. And this means it's actually cheaper so I can walk everywhere. Here's the washing machine. Here's the main, I would say, kitchen. Here's the calf that we live near. We have a calf in actually our apartment, yeah. Hope to see you soon at my apartment. And now I'm gonna go and talk to Fireman Jim to have a taste of my job.
Hey buddy, how you doing? Welcome to Moshfield Fire.
Thank you, and thank you.
This is a combination truck. This is like a ladder truck and a pumper truck, so you can pump water and you can put the ladder up to the buildings if you need it. And my job is to drive this. So how much water is coming in on your gauge? And how much water is going out on each gauge, so you know you don't want to go below zero with the water coming in. So that's how you use math. You have to add up all your pressures for all your different hoses. So basically you get 250 gallons a minute out of this. So you use math to calculate how much gallonage you have. This one you get about 175 gallons a minute, and same on this one. So you use math to calculate how much flow you have coming out of each hose, okay? This is called a hydrant bag. That's how we hook up to the hydrant. We take this valve, this gets attached to the hydrant, and then we use those to tighten it. I'll put extra valves on. And this is the hose. There's around 1,000 feet of hose here. So there's 10 lengths of 100 foot hose. And that's another way we would use math is when you put this hose out, you lose friction on the hose. And what that means is when the water's flowing through it, there's resistance. So every 100 feet of hose you're losing 0.5% of friction loss. If you're going up a hill, it's a little more. Yeah. If you're going downhill, it's better. So you use math to figure out how much friction loss you have.
These ropes here.
A rescue rope. You clip this on, so if you're in a fire and you have to get out a window, you can clip this on the window, clip this on yourself, and you can bail out the window with the hose.
Okay, so how long have you actually been a firefighter for?
I've been a firefighter for 20 years. December 19th is my anniversary date.
Do you use math in your job?
I do use math in my job, mostly for pumping water on the pump on the truck. We also use math when we're in the ambulance because we have to calculate the drugs that we have to put into people, especially children, because you have to calculate their weight.
Yeah.
We use it quite often.
What inspired you to be a firefighter?
I wanted to help people. I thought it would be an exciting job. And also just to take care of my family, make sure I had a good paying job. Some of the costs I have, of course we have to buy food every day, or bring food every day. I have to make sure I belong to a gym because I have to stay in shape, so that's a yearly cost. I also, some equipment that the town doesn't buy, the Montreal Fire Department doesn't buy, so I like to buy some of my own equipment that's a little better than what they supply. Also books, if you want to study to become an officer, or a lieutenant or a captain, you have to buy your books every year. Scanners, there's quite a few expenses.
So, what expense do you have out of your pocket each year?
With all those things included, probably $4,000 to $5,000 a year out of pocket.
How much does each fire truck cost, like every new fire truck?
We just purchased a new truck from E1 in Florida. It was $480,000 for the truck, but we still have to put equipment on it, so it could be another $20,000 in equipment.
So that might be $500,000 for one truck. That's a lot of money.
Yeah, and the trucks usually, you try to make them last 20 years. So after 10 years, you do a renovation on the truck, and then you try to make it last another 10 years.
Yeah. It's time for me to go on a job.
Fire pole down, and we just put this here so people would know.